One day an emperor of China made a wicked plan to take over Nepal. He sent an envoy to the king of Nepal with the message that he would buy Nepal. He also sent a message that if the Nepalese king did not do so, he would conquer Nepal, raising a war. Nepal was such a small country that it could not win over the war with China. Thinking of the problem, the king of Nepal did meditate on the feet of Lord Pashupati. Lord Pashupati appeared to the king in his dream and advised to send a message to the emperor of China saying, "Tell him to cover the blue bull with his wealth, then Nepal will be theirs." Thereafter the god reassured the king saying, "I shall do whatever it needs to be done." The Nepalese king sent his man to check if the blue bull is there in Pashupati or not. Confirming that the blue bull is there, as commanded by Lord Pashupati, he put his condition in front of the envoy of the Chinese emperor. The Chinese became overjoyed and excited, thinking that it would not cost much to cover the bull and soon Nepal would be theirs. They started to pour their wealth on top of the bull. But whatever they poured onto the bull, they could not cover the hump of the bull. They finished all their wealth what they brought with them and returned back to China to bring more, but they never returned. Due to the Chinese wealth, the Pashupati temple is considered to be one of the rich temples in Nepal. Whenever there is a scarcity of money in the country, the money of the Pashupati temple is borrowed.